there's one other thing to say about that tasering incident too, is you'll see that if you watch the video, you'll see it's the chief of police who behind him is standing the police commissioner, who's the city manager, Clovis Watson, supervising this. He orders the officer to pull out the taser, and you see him pointed at me. And it was that officer who wound up resisting what the chief was encouraging him to do, and effectively ordering him to do. The only thing that kept me from being tasered was that officer saying, something's not right here. Mm-hmm. And the officer himself just sort of didn't pull the trigger. Mm-hmm. But you've got a real problem. I mean, this is not a case where you have, you know, the officer on the street making a mistake and the higher-ups trying to cover up for him. This is a case in which you have the chief of police and the police commissioner attempting to misuse the law and the force that they are entitled to carry around. And the officers are just as much victims in this case as I was, and as the citizens were.
So, Charlie, are you banned from Alachua County at this point? Is that what I read?
Well, what happened was, is when I was running for the State House and got arrested for felony wiretapping, for openly recording a public official doing public business, which after 9 months was finally thrown out when I forced it into court. But for 9 months, the court had me banished at the request of the city of Alachua from the city limits, even though I was living there, and even though I was running for the State House of Representatives
banished.
To represent it, banished.
And that was because you were wagging your finger too threateningly?
Because they said that they feared my presence when I walked into City Hall. Mm-hmm. And so I was literally prevented from going. The only thing that I had done in City Hall at that time was, one, review the absentee ballots and then get arrested. Uh-huh. While I was reviewing the absentee ballots. And two, I went to a city commission meeting mm-hmm. where they were going to violate the rules and the law, and I made a point of order, which is a point under Robert's Rules of Order, which
mm-hmm.
is adopted by the city. I said, Madam Mayor, point of order. She banged the gavel. She said, Mr. Grapski, you're out of order. I said, well, no, actually, you're out of order. That's why I'm making a point of order.
You're out of order.
Yes.
She's out of order.
Yes.
They're out of order.
The whole system's
the whole
out,
thing
of
is
order.
Out of order.
That's right. Al Pacino.
Al Pacino.
I think that line sums up what's going on in this case.
Man, it is out of order, isn't it?
But
Alachua County.
But okay. when the court dismissed the case, and literally it took the judge 5 minutes to throw it out, Judge uh-huh. Curtin, but when that was dismissed, the banishment was lifted, and I legally could go and get gas in my own hometown again.
Oh, that's fantastic.
But in December, they started a new tactic, and it started first in the offices of Russian Glassman. I went in to make a public records request to see certain files, because Russian Glassman is the city attorney.
Right.
And Marion Rush, instead of actually asking me what I want and taking the public records request, called the police
right.
to have me thrown out of there, and then banned me for a year from going back.
Unreal. Why is Robert Rush doing this case? He's a guy on the side of right. This is a guy that he's in the wrong team. What's he doing over there? I know Robert Rush, and I don't understand why he is on that side of the team.
Well, a lot of us have been wondering the same thing, and a lot of people have been very, very disappointed with Robert's behavior in this. But what happened is Robert Rush got the position of city attorney contracted to his law firm.
So he has to do it.
And he has assigned his sister the role of the day-to-day work of the city attorney. And he just takes on any defense case, even though they never actually ask him to do it. And there's a conflict of interest, particularly since his sister is getting him into a lot of these problems, giving them bad legal advice.
Is everybody in Alachua County related to each other?
Yeah, I learned today that Robert Rush is so fearful for his life and safety that he's gone to the court after erupting in the courtroom the other day, and we've got video of that on TV20.
We'll show it.
But after erupting in the courtroom, he's now asked for the court to enter a protective order to protect him from me. So mm-hmm. that way I can't go anywhere near him or his firm. And he's already got a trespass.
Mm-hmm.
The state attorney actually tried to do the same thing when I was representing myself as my own attorney in the wiretapping case. They said that because I was demanding to actually coordinate the depositions like I was required to do under law and to share copies of the filings with the opposing attorney, that was somehow stalking the state attorney and his secretary.
and they needed the court to enter a protective order to protect the state attorney and now the city attorney from my dangerous presence.
Well, let's take a look at that video now of what caused this this action to happen and see just how threatening it really was to our audience.
Okay.
Get out of my face. Get out of my face. Don't get in my face again, sir. I'm going to call the police.
That's Grapski and the city's attorney, Robert Rush. A few weeks ago, after city officials said incomplete paperwork disqualified Grapski and two other candidates. Today, a judge said the candidates' original paperwork did qualify them. He said that also means that Grapski can't change his paperwork to run in a different district against unopposed Mayor Gene Calderwood. Today, both sides claimed victory.
The city can't kick him out of City Hall anymore like they tried to do, and Judge Roundtree basically made him go home with their tail between the legs.
It only validates that the city certainly did the right thing. We did the right thing by having an emergency meeting to allow the applicants on the ballot.
Months ago, city officials banned Charles Grapski from City Hall for what they called inappropriate behavior there. Today, the judge was prepared to rule on that, but now says the city says that he was actually banned for only one day.
You've sort of got a confluence, and this is really going on in Alachua too. You have an old good old boy system and a new good old boy system coming together. Mm-hmm. The old ones have been here forever. The new ones are now this, I mean, this Alachua County is poised to be the sort of staging ground for the South Floridization of North Florida.
So do we like the new good old boy system better than the old good old boy system?
Good old boy systems are good old boy systems. They're antiquated dinosaurs that need to be extinct.
And hence, Citizen Grapski arrives.
Yes.
Wow, look at the cheese plate.
Excellent.
Did I plug the wine and cheese gallery yet? I think I'm doing that now.
Are you guys going to be ordering for the menu as well?
This is it. This is it. Thank you very much. Well, we're going to eat some wine and cheese, and we'll be right back with Charles Grapski.
Now, we were told that there is a three-ring binder that was being used during the election to record information about absentee ballots. Is that correct?
It was an aid, and it was part of the way we did it. We did it, as I said before, with notes, stickies, word of mouth, because there are two of us, and sometimes not very often a third person would take
care. Where is that three-ring binder now?
Probably assimilated back into the earth because it was disposed of along with all the other miscellaneous parts that went to compile the final listing.
Yeah, this is the High Springs Herald, which actually is a weekly local newspaper that has done a great job. It's been the best news coverage of this story. And you can see on this one day right before the elections case was going to go to trial from last year's election, they did four stories picking up the front page.
Right.
And many of these photos are from our video depositions.
This is all related to you.
This is all related to Alachua and me and what's been going on. This is Gene Calderwood. She's the mayor.
Okay.
Who was first appointed by Jeb Bush to fill that seat.
Right. Does she have a taser?
She doesn't have a taser,
okay,
but she's the one who threw me out of the meeting that caused me to get into the taser incident.
I see.
This is Clovis Watson.
He has a taser.
He carries two guns.
Mm-hmm.
He's the city manager, but he's also the police commissioner, the city clerk, the canvassing board member, the supervisor of the elections, which he's actually given to his deputy clerk, Alan Henderson.
That's how they do it on the Andy Griffith Show. What's wrong with that?
Well,
one guy with six positions.
This ain't Mayberry. but James Lewis and another group of these good old boys have been basically using that city as a public investment firm for themselves.
I see.
For the past several generations, and now that new good old boy system with the Walmarts and the big dollar money coming in for the growth of North Florida and Jeb's get rid of the panhandle and call it the Great Northwest. All of that stuff is now getting that sort of development interest into this corrupt little town.